गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आई होप माई वॉइस इज क्लियर एंड ऑडिबल। प्रभाकर सर, कैन यू हियर मी?
Yeah, I can hear you.
ग्रेट, ओके। सो वी कैन सी मेनी ऑफ पीपल आर जॉइनिंग अस फॉर द वेबिनार। टूडेज वेबिनार वी आर गोइंग टू हैव ऑन क्लाउड नेटिव डेवलपमेंट्स। सो लेट्स वेट फॉर couple of minutes more for more participants to join. Okay, so we can see many of people have already joined us. Good morning, people. Pallavi Desai from Novel Vista. I am your host and moderator for this webinar today, and I hope my voice is clear. So today's webinar is about topic cloud native development. So I'll quickly introduce Novel Vista. Novel Vista is one of the largest training organizations with huge portfolio of more than 2000 plus courses and team of 300 plus trainers who are associated with us. It's been long time we are doing such knowledge sharing activities, and webinar is one of those where we introduce our industry speakers who deliver such webinars and with the expertise area of their knowledge. And with great pleasure, I would say we are going to extend this activity for complete May month and June month. So to get all the updates regarding our webinars, you can WhatsApp on this message. You can simply send message on this to get all the updates and notification of our upcoming webinars. Okay, so moving ahead, let me quickly introduce our speaker today. So our speaker of the webinar for cloud native development is Mr. Prabhakar Mishra. Prabhakar Mishra is the senior solution architect in cloud. He is strategically focused business oriented technical leader in solution architect and IT solution implementation with 11 years of experience. He has rich solution experience in various technology for cloud offerings, AWS, Google Cloud, DevOps, Kafka, Spark, Kubernetes, and OpenShift with microservices. Till now, he has delivered many microservices developer bootcamp in India, Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore, and across the globe. With great experience, he has been awarded at various platforms with a few names to mention as Eminence Excellence Award in 2018, Service Excellence Award in 2018 again, Spark Award in 2017. So I would like to request Mr. Prabhakar to initiate this session by sharing his knowledge and experience with all our participants.
Thanks, Pallavi. Thanks for introductions. I hope you are able to hear me.
Yes, I can.
So thanks. Good morning, guys. So if anyone have any issue related to anything, they can just ping in the chat. So we will, if you are facing any issues or any kind of concern, you can just drop your message. So I'm just, okay. Let me. So, Pallavi, I hope you are able to see my screen.
Yes, I can.
So, assuming everyone able to see my screen, guys. Okay, thanks a lot. So, first of all, thanks a lot for joining the webinar. And good morning. So, myself, Prabhakar, and Pallavi already given the introduction. So, we can just jump up related to cloud native development. So nowadays, suddenly, a lot of buzz is coming in world, cloud native application, microservice, container. There's a lot of new technology coming around in the globe. Okay, and since it quite possibly bit technical, so I just wanted to touch upon those terms as well. So what we are going to get here, so agenda would be, what is the cloud native application? Introducing new architecture style, designing microservice, container, agile, benefit of your cloud native development, DevOps summary, deploying cloud native application, and cloud native application lifecycle. These are the points which I can touch upon quickly, a small, small point. Then we will talk about fully cloud native. So now when we talk about the cloud native, so cloud native, it is not only for cloud. First thing, so when the word comes cloud, it does not mean it is only for cloud. So when you are developing any application, it could be deployed anywhere. But since we are doing the development or the application development many decades, there's a lot of issues while we are doing the development. What is the challenge? There's a lot of challenge in the sense of, one, agility. Second, scalability. So if we are using the application, any point of time I wanted to scale, there's some issues. Availability. So there's the third issue which we are facing, the availability. Our system could be 24/7 available. If I'm doing my deployment, then also it could be available. If something is horrible happen, then also some services need to available. Now, related to your scalability, availability, agility, and resiliency. So somebody said, maybe some CTO said, whenever you design your cloud native application, you design for failure. Means, since it is the distributed system now we are entering, and there is a lot of services which we develop, it could be in any network, it could be anywhere. So distributed services, we need to design for failure. So what we are going to do today, we are not talking about anything related to a specific only cloud. Yes, definitely, whatever application we are going to develop, that can be in the cloud also. And why? Because now everybody is adopting the cloud. So obviously, we need to design our service if we are going to deploy in on-premises or any private data center or any private cloud or any public cloud. I don't need to change even single line. Without doing the code change, I can move to cloud. Or cloud to on-premises, that also I can do. If we are able to get, this kind of application development, probably we are good. So keeping in mind, we are going to, while we are saying cloud native development, so first we need to create the cloud native applications. So we need to create the cloud native application, and then we will see what option and how we can deploy. Now the process of cloud native application, which initiate from beginning, it could from planning to your end of your monitoring your workloads. So when we talk about, so what is the cloud native? Cloud native is an approach of designing and building modern distributed applications. The approach is supported by four essential pillars. So if you see the four essential pillars, so ideally I can, if you are from management, so ideally it could be your agile could come first, but I just put in the last, since we are more talking about the technical terms. So first things, when we talk about the cloud native, we need to adopt our architecture style. We need to change our architecture style. If we are doing that, is good. And how and what we need to change, we will talk about it. So a cloud native application consists of discrete reusable components known as a microservice that are designed to integrate into any cloud environment. Again, it's within a cloud environment, means whenever you want to change or you wanted to go further. So suppose currently I develop my application in the on-premises. If I wanted to go in the cloud, I don't need to change a single line related to code. I understand quite possibly there could be configuration changes. It seems okay. But I don't need to change single line in the code. And as the it's microservice as an architecture style, how we need to adopt those architecture style, we will see. So this is the first things, a first essential pillar in the cloud native development. The second is container. These microservices act as a building blocks. So why? Because when we talk about the microservice, my any component can be scaled any point of time. So let's take a small use case, which take like Amazon. Amazon have the various functionality, and I'm assuming everyone is using the Amazon, right? So when we talk about the search, when we talk about the payment, billing, different component altogether. Whenever we design a microservice, we need to decompose based on a business capability. What is the business capability? The business capability in the sense of domain driven. Now, if you see here in the Amazon itself, we have the various functionality. First, search, for payment, billing, car, maybe various, right? Now, any point of time, I'm thinking my search could be a business capability where any point of suddenly I am getting the more spike. Probably people are not purchasing more. Maybe they are not doing the more, billing will get the less hit. Maybe something, some other component is getting very, very less hit. Means that particular component can be scaled any point of time. If I'm able to create this kind of architecture style, it could be better. So supporting your architecture, we need the container. It could be building blocks and often package a container. In one container can be launched any sort of application which have one business capability. So I wanted to scale same business capability, I can create multiple container. That doesn't matter. Whenever I wanted to descale, I can descale those containers simply. So we will talk about the container also. So, and it's not going to practical, but little bit I've talked about all these four pillars. Now, third, DevOps. Since we talk about it, business capability could be many. In the one application which we are using, the monolithic application, it could be many small services. Now we decompose. When we decompose, so initially, suppose I'm using the one application, now I'm business capability is 20. So if I'm using the 20 business capability, means 20 deployable component. Those can be WAR, JAR, that doesn't matter. But those 20, who is going to manage? Nobody, right? Since once you have one application, probably somebody can deploy manually, somebody can test manually, somebody can do everything manually. But when you have the 20, and think about the large enterprise architecture way or large enterprise organizations, nobody is going, where you have the 900 application, nobody can do the manual anything. So supporting your this architecture, we need to have the DevOps. And DevOps is nothing, it's a culture of your development and operation team to work jointly and produce your robust software or good quality software. Now microservice work together as a whole to comprise an application. It each can be independently scaled, continuously improved and quickly integrated through automation and orchestration process. Means it could have the separate CI/CD pipeline. Whenever I wanted to deploy this one service separately, I can. It could not impact other services. Now supporting your, again, the same architecture, kind of microservice architecture, we need to adopt the Agile also. The flexibility of each microservice adds to the agility and continuous improvement of cloud native applications. So it is a process where everywhere you need to, and why the Agile is come in the market? Because we wanted to just ship our small component immediately, go to market easily, okay? So these, now, if we clubbed all four essential packages, we can call a cloud native development, a cloud native application creations using your microservices, using your shipping as a container, using your DevOps, using your Agile. If these four essential services we are using the cloud native application development. Now we will understand one by one these four, and then we will understand what the benefit we are going to get. Okay, so there is a poll which before that I wanted to conduct, since we wanted to understand what kind of strength we have related to these. So those are the small questions like do you have a previous experience in the cloud native, or your current workload is a kind of cloud native in its structure. So Pallavi, go for the two questions related to poll.
Sure. So here is the first question that you can see on your screen.
And those question is nothing, it's just wanted to understand what level you are. So based on that, we can check where we can adjust.
Okay, so people have vote for the same. Let's display the result. Okay, so we can see 82% people have voted as still they have not worked in cloud native development environment yet. So this webinar is going to help them a lot to learn more about this functionality. Great. So let's go ahead with the another question. Shall I display the another question, sir?
Yeah, you can go ahead for all three, no problem. One by one.
Continue. All right. So let's display the results. So we can see 57% people have voted as they're adopting, their organization is adopting cloud native development process. Great. So let's go ahead with the last question. Okay, so we have displayed the poll for the last question as well. Sir, do you want to say anything on the same?
No, just wanted to tell the result as of now. That's okay. Then we can go ahead. We don't have much
okay,
time.
Okay, so 38% people have voted for this, where they were already perfect. Using. Perfect. Okay.
Thanks, team. So let's understand introducing the new architecture style, which I talk about the four pillars. So first pillar, we are going to talk about it. Now, why this architecture is required, first of all, because there's the four things which I talk about it, which is first, improve time to market, means agility. Nobody wanted to, so suppose some small changes, as I've taken the example one, Amazon. So let's take the same example. I wanted to change something only in the search. If I'm using the your full, whatever we did, the monolithic style or SOA style, all my services is tightly coupled. If all are the tightly coupled, if I wanted to make a small change in the search, it quite possibly I need to do full testing, full functionality, because might be possible in that particular bundle or deployable component, my payment is also there, search is also there, my billing is also there, every function, business functionality is inside one deployable component. But I wanted to change only search. However, this is the small business functionality. If it is the small functionality, why I need to deploy all the functionality? Again, it take a lot of time. So we wanted to improve the time to market. Now, as I said, if I wanted to scale only search component, could I do the monolithic style? No, because if I wanted to do, since all my business capability in the one deployable component, possibly I cannot. So this architecture forced me to, because there's the, so when we talk about the related to our compromises, probably I need the infrastructure and it take a lot of time for getting the infrastructure. Since we are already in the cloud and moving our most of the workload in the cloud, so what is required? My code is automatically scale any point of time. Since we are already getting info and all detail within the minute or 2 minutes. So what is the blocking? Now blocking is my code where I need wanted only my search capability to increase, but here my search capability is not a single capability or it's not a single deployable component. So first I need to make the each business capability need to decompose. So this is also second requirement, which is scale on the demand. More resiliency. So if something is big, so suppose one component is big, probably my full application is going to break. I don't want to do it. Definitely if search is having some issue, definitely search can be big. And I wanted to fix the search, that seems okay. But other functionality, which can be payment, which can be billing, it cannot be big. When I talk about the availability, means if I have the problem in the only search, probably my other system, so every thread is going to block. Maybe I'm, and search is only issue, but everybody is still searching and it's a heavy issue. Because of that, might be possible my all thread is going to choke, or maybe I'm getting the issue in the availability. So we need to force these things to adopt the new architecture style. Now, if you see, yes, they had already tried with the SOA. So they already tried with the SOA, but they failed. Why? There's the some visions in the SOA. SOA is always talk about your integrations of many enterprise application. Here, in the the new architecture style, which we talk about the microservices, those forced me to decompose our business capability. Now, if you see, we have the SOA now improved time to market, scale on time, more resiliency, resilient system, which we are creating. So more resilience we are expecting and availability. Now, if you see, think to real world use cases, is the SOA able to introduce new feature quickly? Have you ever seen a SOA in the cloud? So what we are going to develop in the cloud native, we are going to develop the cloud native application can be deployed anywhere. It could be on-prem, it could be your hybrid cloud, it could be your private cloud, it could be your public cloud, that doesn't matter. So your code is going to develop, which can be anywhere. That doesn't matter. Now, if we are going to achieve, now SOA is restricting. Is SOA able to disgrade gracefully? If I wanted to descale or scale, can I do in gracefully? No, it's a lot of issues in the SOA itself. Now, if you see, this is the one application which is all bundled, which is the search functionality, recommendations, wish list, many functionality inside. So same which we I talked about it. So you can take now my search is request, my search demand is 5 billion or 10 million or 20 million request per minute. However, if you see admin component, which is the inside a bundle, which probably it create an issue, right? So that possibly, right? Then what is the meaning? Meaning is based on my request, I wanted to scale. I don't want to scale my admin also, since it's have only 5 requests per minute. However, if you see the search, it could be 2 million, 3 million, 5 million hit I'm expecting per minute. So which one I need to scale? I need to scale both or only one? I wanted to scale my one capability because I'm based on the hit, I wanted to scale my info. Okay, if you see, there's the load balancer. This is the purely monolithic kind of Right. Now, monolithic is simple to develop, test and deploy, but if project is alive, it go and become a wallop model. Means when it's go and if you see and do the waterfall model, etc., it is a difficult to manage later. How? We will talk about it. It is too large for any single developer to full understanding. Now, startup time could take from 10 to 15 minutes. Whenever we are doing the deployment, if I have the full functionality, probably it take 5 minutes, 10 minutes deployable time. Nobody will wait 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Wait. A bug in the any module can potential bring downtime also. So if, as I described, if search has the bug, probably it could be my full application can also restore or maybe downtime. We don't want this. So these are the problem area which we wanted to know. If you see Netflix, so this use case which taken even a decade before, Netflix was still operating as a monolithic. A single missing semicolon brought down the entire Netflix website for several hours. So they already experienced. Once they experienced, after that, now they are using the fully microservice or distributed application architecture. And nowadays, you probably know only the DVD company, but nowadays they are providing lot of library related to your open source project. And they are the huge contributor of your open source. Now, cloud native application. Now we are entering how we need to develop. Yes, probably you are right. Able to live in the distributed system. What is the distributed system? If we see the distributed system, if you see the distributed system, so distributed system is a system whose components are located on different network computer which communicate each other. How they are using any protocol, any messaging protocol, probably it could be any protocol, HTTP, AMQP, any protocol, that doesn't matter. So here we are talking about the distributed system. Now, if you see, adopting a microservice architecture pattern leverage on infrastructure automated. As I said, when you talk about the microservice development, probably you need to change your culture, change your infrastructure also based on the two things. When you adopting this architecture, first, DevOps and automation is essential. Nobody can deny on it. It could be on-prem or cloud using the DevOps and tool. So if you see adopting a microservice architecture pattern, leverage on infrastructure automations using DevOps tools and culture. What do you mean? Means we will see how we can design. If you see here, you already aware about the first one, which is the monolithic application divided by technology, where you have the presentation layer, business logic, a DAO layer, all in the one bundle. Right? And any request is coming, probably it landed to your presentation layer, business layer, and then DAO. And DAO, once you connected to your database, right? So you have the one probably database. Now, if you see microservice application divided by domain, it could always divided by domain and based on the business capability. Now, each request come in the API gateway. What is the API gateway? That is the one basic component where you have the routing, security, multiple things which you need to enable. If you see each service, billing, passenger, driver, payment, driver, all are the separate component. Each component separately deployed, tested, managed, monitor separately. Now, whenever we have the one application, probably we can monitor quickly. But whenever we break 1 to 20, probably it is difficult to monitor. Means you need to adopt all the automation. As we talk about it, everything should be isolated. When everything is isolated, means your infrastructure also work as a service or I work as a code. When you need to automate any point of time, if your infrastructure can be create the any workload, scale, descale, deploy, everything you can do. So your infrastructure should be fully automated using any sort of technology, maybe DevOps you are using, maybe any escape, whatever you are using, that is the different task. Now, microservices are small autonomous services that work together. All microservices must be independently deployable and upgradable. Microservice must respect a single responsible principle. As I said, search is only responsible search. That doesn't matter. It is not belong to any payment, billing, anything. Since search is only, and when you are changing the search, it could be only reason to change the only search functionality. It could not be any other reason for the change. So developer cannot do any changes if search is not going to change. So each would have the single responsible principle. If you talk about it, so single responsibility. So in the microservices, so if you see anyone is more interested, they can learn solid principle. So solid principle will adopted by microservices. Now some microservices expose an API that's consumed by others. So when we talk about it, one service need to call another service. So since we are in the distributed world, right, might be possible one service is deployed in one network, second service can deploy in the second network as well. How they need to communicate? They need to communicate by any sort of protocol, etc. Now other microservices communicate with each other using asynchronous or synchronous, that doesn't matter. Some of the services which can be sync, which can be async also, based on your use cases. Now if you see, each service are independent, it could be have the separate database also. So if you see, each service, so passenger, driver, tip, all are the separate. If I wanted to scale, I can scale separately any point of time. The microservice architecture pattern impacts the relationship between application and the database. Each of service has its own database. Microservice architecture or new architecture, cloud native architecture, which help, and you can, based on your business capability, you can choose your best technology. I itself now, I did not talk about, you can develop your this architecture in which technology, any technology, maybe Node.js, Java, maybe Python, or any sort of technology that depend upon your project, depend upon you. A service can use a type of database that is best suited to its need. It's often result in duplications of some data, but it is necessary to ensure loose coupling. As we talk about all of the loose coupling, isolations. So these are the basic principles about the microservice. If you see your customer service, you have the three services. All these related to only customer service. If you hear also, so if you see, the orchestrations need to direct the change things at one time. The downside in this orchestration suppose is that customer service can become too much of the central governance. So every time whenever I wanted to change these also, and my customer service is going to a governance policy. Now if you see here, choreography is the decided to design time, but you can change frequently thanks to CI or CD. You need to, when you are using, so any point of time you wanted to customer create event, you can. The downside is to monitor these too many services or complex many services you need to monitor. So that's what we are talking nowadays, a lot of tool using the taking tool support, we are creating all automations. It could be my monitoring, it could be anything, that doesn't matter. Now, as I talk about the API gateway, which is the single responsible for routing my all calls, API gateway is responsible for request routing, compositions, and protocol translations. All requests from client first go through your API gateway, then it routed to your request appropriate microservice, because it's maintain your client-side load balancing, it maintain your security, it maintain your service discovery. When it look up the service discovery, based on the service discovery, whatever node it is available or whatever your pod is available, it route only available pods. So that is possible via API gateway. It might have other responsibilities such as the authentication, monitoring, load balancing, caching, request shaping, and management that static response handle. So these are the, if you see, there is the various API, which can be have the Netflix API, and here we have multiple call. If you see, 9 network call collapsed into one. WAN network latency cost paid only once. If you see, client logic pushed to server, the 20 plus redundant call has been removed. So this is also an advantage. Now if you see one more advantage, so whenever we are getting the call, it could be go to API gateway, and API gateway will have the load balancer. Now service discovery, which is one more concept, where it have all your service. If you see, service registry would have all your registry of all services. So your load balancer, before routing to a specific node, it look up your service discovery. How many these services? So one service might be possible in the 4 nodes deployed, 2 nodes. So it automatically take whatever available node it will route based on your load balancer. Load balancer directly talking to your service discovery. So any point of time you are scaling and descaling your pods, that doesn't matter. Now network location of a service instance is registered with the service registry when it start up. It is removed from the service discovery or service registry when the instance terminated. The service instance registration is typically refreshed periodically using the heartbeat mechanism. So there's the based on their heart, whenever they up, automatically they will register. It is service registry is not going to take the data. So they are going to give the data by a heartbeat or something. Whenever you need to start any service, it takes. Now if you see, so any point of time you can, so this pattern called the circuit breaker pattern. So somebody very beautifully said, design your application for failure. When you ready for failure, so suppose I am accessing XYZ service, that service is fail, what will next? It is not my job, because that service is the third party, quite possibly it's a third party service. It is my service, probably I can still look. But if it is the third party service, I'm doing the integration with maybe SBI service, what will I do? Then also I need to create some fallback mechanism. If something is not there or something is big, what I need the fallback mechanism. I need to use that. Now, everything seems okay in this architecture. The only problem related to data consistency, which we talk about when we do the VTEC MCA, we talk about the ACID mechanism. So this is the only things which is we need to compromise in the microservice. So you know there's the CAP theorem. So CAP theorem will give the consistency, availability, and your partitional tolerance. So always you will achieve, or you need to pick 2 of 3. So we have the 3, we need to pick 2. It always will give you the 2. Now if you see the service, when I call, so if you see one service which is the order table, second service which is the customer table. I wanted to take some data from the customer's table, I don't need to go directly. I need to go by a service. So this particular service needs something related to customer data, definitely they can not go by a direct call the customer table, because it's more, again, you are making the tightly coupled. As the principle, it is the loosely coupled. So it will go by the customer service. Now, deploying cloud native application. So one part which is related to our development, how we need to create our development, how we need to create our application. Now, what we are moving ahead, we are moving how we need to deploy. So we created multiple services which we need to deploy now. Now we have the many options. One is the virtual machine, second is the container, third is the container can be anywhere. It could be your public cloud, private cloud, or anywhere. Now we will take 2 things. One is the VMs, and then we will take the container, how we need to. And those container can be created anywhere. As you know, most of the container which can be cloud is now in picture, and you can get the info immediately. So it could be more realistic use case to do the deployment in the container way. So virtual machine need more care and feeding. Now if you need, see, name the VMs, tune in, groom regularly, feed pet with the good food, take pet the vet when they are sick. Now if you see there something is gone, then you need to go and connect to your VMs. You don't have other option. if you see the container or cloud server, if you see VM is not unique. Now tune in room app, not the cater. Now replace when necessary. Now kill it when they are sick. Means any container is now not available, let him kill. Immediately we need to adopt and we need to deploy the second, create the second container. However, my code is one place. So using this, you already know many sort of technology available like Docker, Kubernetes, etc. So using those, we will create our infra as a container way. If we have, so one is the microservice, second is if we create those a deployment as a container, we will get more power. Now if you see, these are the differences why the container nowadays coming or we are going to adopting. Now if you talk about the VMs, heavyweight, lightweight, so if you see here these images, what is the main differences? The main differences is each application which you are going to, in the each VMs, every VM we have their own OS. Whenever you deploy any service in their own VMs, it what will have its own OS, it take lot of time. And since it's already have the separate OS, it create lot of starting time as well. So if you see limited performance, each VM run its own OS. Now hardware level virtualization, so only they are getting the hardware level virtualization. Startup time in a minute. Now allocate required memory. We need to allocate 5 GB, 6 GB, whatever we want. We need to state forward need to allocate. We cannot spin our memory based on the whatever I have. So we will see in the container. So I have the 10 GB. If anything is free, I can create immediately the second container. Right now, fully, if you see the VMs, fully isolated and hence more secure. It is more secure, but we can achieve all the security level in the container also. Since if you see, we have only one host OS, and there would be some container engine. It may be Docker, ACL, Linux container. So Docker is most popular. So that's what I put in the Docker engine. Now, if you see, what is required? Your code is required. Based on the code dependency, where you have a lot of library and all, you can each separate container, you can create any number of container. And so as I said, suppose it's a half the 10 GB, any number of container you can, if any point of time it is not going to use those 10 GB, it can be destroyed and create again. Okay, so what is the benefit of the container? Lightweight, native performance. All containers share the host OS. So they don't have their separate OS. OS level virtualization. However, if you see, VM is the hard level virtualization. Now startup time in the, this is the beauty, right? Since if you are getting the container startup time in the milliseconds, means you already have the image and everything, your code or library, everything in place somewhere. In they can, your all code can be compiled and deployed within the millisecond. So this is the one of the major important aspect we are going as a container. Required less memory space. Now process level isolation, possibly less secure. So we can, as we talked about, we need to create the orchestration and all. We can make the secure for this. However, if I compare VM in this, probably less secure. But it does not mean we don't make the secure. Now, if you see, I created one container, and that container can be deployed anywhere. Means it could be your development VMs, it could be your QA server, it could be your cluster data center. Public cloud, private, that doesn't matter. Now means first I need to create the container. What the container will have? Container will have your image. What image? Image will have your code, dependencies, all these details basically. So an engine that enable any payload to encrypt, a lightweight, portable, self-sufficient container. So self-setting means one business capability in one image, and that create a container, and container can ship anywhere, run, ship anywhere, no matter which environment you are going to use. So that can be manipulated using standard operations and run consistently on virtually any hardware platform. As I said, it could be same container or same when you create image and all, same container can be run any. It could be your UAT environment, it could be your pod environment, it could be your SIT environment, everywhere. As I said, when you develop the microservice where you don't need to change your code based on the your environment, it can be deployed anywhere. I'm not talking about the configuration and all. That you need to manage separately. So some configuration and all, which is part of your microservice, which you can see how you can centralize and version controlling configuration you need to manage. Now, this is the one Docker technology, which is, if you see, Docker file, which is giving the instructions. Now, image, we can create the image. What the image will have? Image will have all your detail about your code, your library, your other dependencies. You can push and pull your image in the Docker registry. So Docker registry is only for push and pull, or provide you repository to store your image. Similarly, you have the Google container registry, AWS, many container registry like Git, where you can just do the code. Here you can just pull image you can deploy. Now, if you see, when you run this image, it create a container. Okay, once create, you can stop, start all container, and those container can run anywhere. So just wanted to now you Docker Compose is a tool of defining and running multi container Docker applications. Now these are the Swan Hub, how I already talked about it, where you can just do the publish or save your images. Now this is related to OpenShift, where we can, this is the orchestrations, right? And everything is there, where you have this, if you see registry pod, all are your separate containers. You're using the Docker technology. This is the Kubernetes, which managing, and here is the OpenShift, where you have the DevOps and all this. It's already inbuilt functionality. Now, cloud native application lifecycle, where we can use the DevOps and CD. So we talk about two things. One is the architecture. Second, we talk about the container. Now we are entering in the DevOps quickly. So DevOps is the bigger terms, but I'm just quickly talk about the two, three minutes. Now, when we talk about the creation of the microservice, we already need the cross-functional team, because we are following mostly the domain-driven approach. The idea is to have the cross-functional team. Now, two pieces, which AWS CEO, Amazon CEO given the idea, how it is the two pieces is going to not sufficient for the full team. How so that you can already, most of the know people you know probably. Now, projects, not projects. So when we talk about project, now we are talking about team responsible for services. So whatever service I am going to develop, I am responsible for that service. I am not responsible for full project. I am only responsible for my service. Okay. So team responsible for service should own a product over its full lifetime from development to maintenance. So if I develop one service, I am full responsible for all the cost lifecycle. Now, if you see a team able to develop, deploy, test services means your microservices from dev to production. A team with all necessary skills, developer, tester, DBA, system admin, and so on. If you see here, so how we are development team, continuous integration, collaborative development, continuous monitoring, feedback, ops team. If you see automated configuration, automated testing, how they are doing small release. If you integrate it in this way, they are going to a team that take responsibility of its for not project, its product. All these things means as a DevOps. Now, so there's a couple of trends of cloud native app, which is composable. So application should be designed small and independent building block, which can be composed to fulfill a specific business function. As I talk about Agile, which is already why we are doing a small sprint, etc. Because we are just wanted to go to market or small stories. We are talking about the product, not project. Now, flexible. So design should promote freedom of changing right technology for right task. I use the search. Search could be, it is not a best database, like our DBMS is the best for the search. Maybe I can NoSQL database, which is the more lighter and faster. I can adopt that. I am not going to a specific bounding for any technology. Each component can be built in the technology best suited. For example, use Python, or mathematically complex services while you have the Node.js or any sort of. Now, programming. Now, design should promote use of the API, which can be used to your construct applications. The business logic is de facto in a such a way that no component crosses its domain boundary. How you need to develop DDD model? So you need to create the business functionality based on the DDD. Now, functionless. So functionless, that transition from development to operations should be seamless, with an aim to automate the entire pipeline, tool set, and manage infrastructure. So these are the trends of the cloud native app. Now, a few things you need to take care. Although cloud native is an approach of choice of building modern application, they have their own set of issues which need careful planning to mitigate. So we need to mitigate those. Now, too many of them. Agile culture, we need to adopt the agile culture, end-to-end responsibility, need for speed, means we are going for scalable, choose wisely. So when we need to talk about technology, we need to choose wisely. Also, once technology is decided, then also probably you need to choose based on the, so as I talk about which service is going to sync or async, you need to choose wisely. Okay, so these are the basics, few things related to which we need to take care while we are going in the cloud native development. Okay, now cloud native in other context. If you see cloud enabled, cloud ready, cloud based, cloud first. Is it really? As I talk about it first, it is not only for the cloud, but it could be for cloud also, right? As I said, when you develop your application, so when we have the any system or application developed, so suppose you are already working in the monolithic, now it need to go to cloud. Start immediately you thinking what need to change, what code you need to change, etc. If you already created the cloud native applications using the cloud native development environment and all, you don't need to think about it. Any point of time, today my application is running in the on form. If any point of time I need to go for the cloud or any cloud, I'm okay. So today I'm using the GCP, tomorrow I'm going to using, if I'm not using any GCP independent, dependent services, I can go anywhere. It could be today AWS, could be IBM cloud, could be your Azure, that doesn't matter. Means a cloud-enabled application in an application that was developed for deploy in a traditional data center, but was later changed. So initially you did in the on-prem, which is in the data center, that it also could run in a cloud environment. As I said, probably today you could be in on-prem, tomorrow could be anywhere. Now, cloud-native application, however, are built to operate only in the cloud. Now, developers design cloud native application to be scalable, platform agnostic, and comprise of your microservices, as we already talked about. Now, cloud ready. So my application could be ready for cloud. Cloud enablement means any point of time I can enable it. Cloud-based service or application is delivered over the internet. It's a general term applied library to any number of cloud offerings. Cloud native is more specific term. Cloud native describe application designed to work in cloud environment. So if you see, the term denotes application that ready on microservice, CI, and CD, which is the continuous integration and continuous delivery can be used via any cloud platform. We are not talking about any specific cloud. Now, cloud first describe a business strategy in the organizations. Commit to using the cloud resources first when launching new IT services. So most of the cloud nowadays, if I talked about today's statistics, it's 40% workload moving to our cloud native cloud native environment or cloud native application going to create it. Now, still there's a lot of chances which coming years, most of the 80-90% workload need to go in the cloud. But prior to that, you need to create the cloud native development or cloud native applications. So these are the details which are packed as a lightweight container, developed with the best build language. So language framework can be anything. Now isolation, so all these details. Now, whenever we talk about the microservice, we must talk about the tall factor. We need to create the application which you need to build with cloud native software as a service using this tall factor. So these are the tall factor: code base, dependency, config, backing services, build, run, release, process, code bonding, concurrency, disposability, dev tall, dev and pod, partitioning, log, admin, process. All these tall factor need to come. And these are the 8 steps for the cloud native. So somebody, Red Hat's given. Now your DevOps culture will be there. Your speeding of your current workload, how you can make it. Use your application service speed development. Choose the right tools. Provide your self-service on demand infrastructures. Any point of time your service wanted to scale, it can be automated. Now you can automate your application delivery, implement a continuous integration and continuous delivery technique, and your modular architecture. If you see, again, any point of time, we are getting the idea and we can work and deploy. So summary is, we need to, if you see before and past, we need to, if we are going to adopt the cloud native development, we need to go as a development architecture style as a microservices. If you see before, we have tightly coupled component, slow deploy cycle. So it's small. So when we have the before a monolithic, my waterfall model, maybe in the 6 months, we have the one or two deployment. Here we are talking about loosely coupled, automated deploy without waiting on individual components. So everyone is working on their own component, they can deploy separately. Now, if you see the container, make sure software match with the hardware, build Snowpack each environment. If you see the container, after how it look like, build once, run anywhere. A shared construct between the software and hardware. Now DevOps, which we talked about, not my problem. Now here, shared your responsibility. Okay, now if you see continuous delivery, so here release once 6 months, here mom. So when you release will go in the 6 months, probably chances is more for the more bug. If you are doing the small delivery, probably you don't have much bug in the final way. Small things, because you are already doing 2-3 weeks deployment, you can get the more output. So this is from my end probably. And some, just give me 1 minute. I wanted to give you some highlights. So here, if you see, we have the cloud native computing foundation where all my technology stuff is allocated here. If you talk about it, Kubernetes, which is developed by Google in 2014, they provide given to this cloud native foundations. So you can develop, and it is the larger community. Most of the project and all has been, if it is related to open source, they need to go as a cloud native. So here you can, so this is the link where you can browse. If you see orchestrations, application, database, streaming, various techniques, and most of the technology is here. So this is from my end. If anyone have any questions, they can go ahead. I will try to answer those questions. So thank you so much. So let's question answer session. Pallavi, are you there?
Yes, so as of now we cannot see any questions. Let people put the questions.
All right.